The colourful canvas, Tom and Susie's painting party of emotions. Tom was a creative and artistic boy who loved to paint. He lived in a small town near a big forest where he often went for walks with his best friend Susie. Susie was a wise and yellow cat who could talk to Tom and teach him many things. One day, Tom and Susie decided to have a painting party in the forest. They packed some paints, brushes, paper, and a big canvas and set off on their journey. "Susie, I can't wait to paint in the forest today," Tom said happily. "Maybe we will paint some animals, or some flowers, or some trees, or some... Or maybe we will paint something even more amazing," Susie interrupted. "Something that will help us learn more about ourselves and our emotions." "What do you mean, Susie?" Tom asked, confused. "Well, Tom, you know that emotions are very important, right? They tell us how we are feeling, what we like and dislike, what we need and want, and how we can relate to others. Emotions are like the colors of the rainbow. They make our lives more colorful and interesting." "I know, Susie, but I don't always understand my emotions. Sometimes I feel happy, sometimes I feel sad, sometimes I feel angry, sometimes I feel scared, sometimes I feel surprised, sometimes I feel disgusted, and sometimes I feel confused. How can I know what I am feeling and why?" "That's a very good question, Tom, and I have a very good answer for you, but you will have to wait and see. Come on, let's go." Tom and Susie continued walking through the forest, enjoying the sights and sounds of nature. They saw squirrels, birds, butterflies, and rabbits. They smelled flowers, pine, and mushrooms. They heard leaves, wind, and water. After a while, they reached a clearing in the forest, where they saw a big easel with a blank canvas. Next to the easel, there was a table with 6 jars of paint, each with a different color and a different label. "Wow, Susie, look at this easel and these paints. They look so fun. Can we use them?" Tom asked excitedly. "Sure, Tom, but first, let me tell you a secret. These are not ordinary paints. These are magical paints. They are called the colors of emotions. They can show you what you are feeling and why, and they can also help you change your feelings if you want to." "Really, Susie? How do they work?" Tom asked, amazed. "Well, Tom, the colors of emotions have 6 colors, each representing one of the 6 basic emotions: happiness, sadness, anger, fear, surprise, and disgust. Each color has a different name, a different shade, and a different symbol. You can see them on the labels. Look!" Susie showed Tom the labels and pointed to the 6 colors. "See, Tom, this is the color of happiness. It's yellow, bright, and has a smiley face. This is the color of sadness. It's blue, dark, and has a teardrop. This is the color of anger. It's red, fiery, and has a flame. This is the color of fear. It's purple, spooky, and has a ghost. This is the color of surprise. It's pink, sparkly, and has a star. And this is the color of disgust. It's green, slimy, and has a worm." "Wow, Susie, that's so cool. But how do we use them?" Tom asked, curious. "Well, Tom, we have to use these brushes. They are also magical. They can sense what you are feeling and pick the color that matches your emotion. For example, if you are feeling happy, the brush will dip into the yellow paint. If you are feeling sad, the brush will dip into the blue paint, and so on." "Wow, Susie, that's amazing. But what if I want to change my feeling? What if I don't like the color I'm using?" "Well, Tom, that's also possible. The brush can also pick another color if you ask it nicely. For example, if you are feeling angry, but you want to feel happy, you can say, 'Brush, please use the yellow paint,' and the brush will do it. But you have to be careful, Tom. You can't change your feelings too quickly or too often. You have to respect your feelings and understand why you have them. Sometimes it's better to use the color you are feeling and paint something with it. You might create something beautiful or find something helpful." "Wow, Susie, that's awesome. I can't wait to try it. Can we start now?" Tom asked, impatient. "Sure, Tom, but remember, this is a painting party of emotions. We are here to learn about our feelings, not to play. So be respectful, be honest, and be open, and have fun." "Okay, Susie, I will. Thank you for bringing me here. You are the best friend ever." "You're welcome, Tom. You are the best friend ever, too." Tom and Susie picked up their brushes and started their painting party of emotions. They used the 6 colors and painted their feelings on the canvas. They also learned how to identify, understand, express, cope, and empathize with their feelings. They had a wonderful time, and they created a colorful masterpiece. The first color they used was the color of happiness, It was yellow, bright, and had a smiley face. Tom and Suzy felt very happy as they painted with this color. They painted a big sun, a bunch of flowers, and a happy face. They also learned how to express their happiness by smiling, laughing, and saying positive things. They learned how to cope with their happiness by sharing it with others, being grateful, and remembering the good moments. They learned how to empathize with others' happiness by congratulating them, celebrating with them, and being happy for them. The second color they used was the color of sadness. It was blue, dark, and had a teardrop. Tom and Suzy felt very sad as they painted with this color. They painted a rainy sky, a wilted flower, and a sad face. They also learned how to express their sadness by talking, writing, or drawing about it. They learned how to cope with their sadness by asking for help, doing something they enjoy, and being kind to themselves. They learned how to empathize with others' sadness by listening, supporting, and being there for them. The third color they used was the color of anger. It was red, fiery, and had a flame. Tom and Suzy felt very angry as they painted with this color. They painted a volcano, a fire, and an angry face. They also learned how to express their anger by using I statements, being assertive, and explaining why they are angry. They learned how to cope with their anger by taking deep breaths, counting to 10, and walking away. They learned how to empathize with others' anger by acknowledging their feelings, apologizing if necessary, and finding a solution. The fourth color they used was the color of fear. It was purple, spooky, and had a ghost. Tom and Suzy felt very scared as they painted with this color. They painted a dark cave, a spider, and a scared face. They also learned how to express their fear by naming it, asking questions, and seeking reassurance. They learned how to cope with their fear by facing it, challenging it, and overcoming it. They learned how to empathize with others' fear by validating their feelings, encouraging them, and helping them. The fifth color they used was the color of surprise. It was pink, sparkly, and had a star. Tom and Suzy felt very surprised as they painted with this color. They painted a rainbow, a present, and a surprised face. They also learned how to express their surprise by saying, "Wow, really?" and "Amazing." They learned how to cope with their surprise by being curious, flexible, and adaptable. They learned how to empathize with others' surprise by showing interest, curiosity, and enthusiasm. The sixth and last color they used was the color of disgust. It was green, slimy, and had a worm. Tom and Suzy felt very disgusted as they painted with this color. They painted a garbage can, a rotten apple, and a disgusted face. They also learned how to express their disgust by saying "yuck," "gross," and "no way." They learned how to cope with their disgust by avoiding it, changing it, or accepting it. They learned how to empathize with others' disgust by respecting their preferences, boundaries, and values. Tom and Suzy had a wonderful time on their painting party of emotions. They learned a lot about their feelings, and they created a colorful masterpiece. They looked at their canvas and admired their work. They saw a beautiful mix of colors, shapes, and symbols. They saw their emotions and they felt proud. Suzy, I had so much fun today. I learned so much about my feelings and yours. You are the best friend ever. Tom, I had so much fun too. I learned so much about your feelings and mine. You are the best friend ever too. Tom and Suzy walked back to their town feeling happy, sad, angry, scared, surprised, and disgusted. But most of all, they felt loved.